Yes. Can I take the question from the sister's side, please? Is there any non-Muslim sister there?
Yes. Assalamu alaikum. I'm Deepa. I'm in Islam from last 3 years, and inshallah, I will be till my death.
Inshallah.
But main question is it compulsory for me to marry a Muslim guy or a Hindu guy? Since it is very hard task for me in the society to marry a Muslim guy.
Sister said, mashallah, she accepted Islam 3 years back, and she intends being on Islam till she dies. Mashallah, as you know, die not except in the state of Islam. Verse of the Quran, mashallah. But the question is that, is it compulsory that she should marry a Muslim boy? Is it compulsory? Yes, sister. Because Quran clearly mentions in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 221, that marry not an unbelieving woman, marry not a mushrika, an idolatress, until she believes. A believing woman, even if she may be a bondswoman, she is much better than an unbelieving woman, even if she allows you. That means in Quran, a man has to marry a Muslim, a believing woman. A believing woman who's a bondwoman, she may be a servant, she may be ugly, she's far superior than an unbelieving woman, an idolatress, even if she allows you, even she may be the beauty queen, she may be the wealthiest woman in the world, a believing woman is far superior. And the verse continues, do not marry unbelieving man, do not marry a mushrik, do not marry an idolater, until he believes. A believing man, he may be a bondsman, he may be a servant, he may be ugly, he is far superior than an idolater, an unbelieving man, even if he allows you. He may be the most handsome man in the world, he may be the richest man in the world, but a believing man is far superior than an unbelieving man, than an idolater, even if he allows you. So sister, you have to marry a Muslim. You know why? If you have a vehicle, imagine a vehicle which has four tires, one tire is of a cycle and the other is of a truck. Do you think it will run? No. All the tires should be same. And if you know that Islam is the way that will get you salvation, and you have accepted Islam 3 years back, and you have promised you'll be on Islam till you die, why do you want your husband to go to hell? When we say to the spouse, we say better half. So even husband, if not better half, at least he's your worst half. But at least he's your half. So if you marry husband, if you are a good wife, don't you want your husband to go to Jannah? Don't you want your husband to go to paradise? So if you are a good lady, sister, but natural, you would even want your husband to go to Jannah. You may have some problems. I understand there'll be difficulty in this world. The society may not accept you. But this life, sister, is for a small duration, average 50, 60 years. Some people die at the age of 10, some 20, some 50, some 90, some 100. Average 50, 60 years you're going to live. Even if you take the turmoil, the pain, for 50, 60 years, the next life is eternal, sister. As a businesswoman, it's a very good bargain. You have trouble, pain, difficulties, 50, 60 years. Next life, eternal, everything good. So sister, even if it's difficult for you, yet sister, my advice to you is, bear those difficulties. Marry a Muslim boy, even if he's not good, even if he's poor, even if he's ugly, he'll be much superior than the most handsome man or the most wealthiest man if he's an idolater, if he's a non-believer. Hope that answers the question, sister.